Oh my god, this is not how what is happening. The subscribing potato, what the heck? I didn't have any time to record this week. As you may or may not have heard, I am currently working to renovate a house. So I don't have a lot of time and honestly, I was just stupid. So yeah, I recorded some stuff in the house. So this will be a tiny special video about the house. I also wanted to quickly note that most of these recording were for friends of mine to just show the house really fast. So most of them will have a dumb resolution. Wasn't expecting to like make a video out of them. So this is the first floor. I don't really know what I want to explain in this video because I can't give you a lot of the details because it's a private thing of my parents. So I will just drop some facts about the house. The house is old. It was finished in 1930. What you are seeing is basically the first day we began to like do shit in the house. You saw the video where I removed the cupboard from life. Like I said, it was finished in 1930 from one family and was inherited over three generations. The last generation is now really, 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 really old. This woman that lived there, a really, really old lady, was now moved to home for old people. I don't have a fucking clue how this is called in English. The new guy that now owns it, he didn't want to lose it, but as far as we know, his wife somewhat forced him to sell it. So there are a lot of funny historical facts about this house. First things first, we searched the house a little bit, and as far as my best guess goes, the builder of the house was an instructor for German soldiers. I am guessing this because we found a lot of books talking about how to instruct new soldiers, basic war tactics. But we know he was a soldier because we found like his uniform, like there was a hidden chamber. We found his boots as well as we found the remains of a Stahlhelm. But back to the house. So it was built as a tiny farm, like they have big garden, as well as they had in the basement, integrated in the basement, swine, chicken, and goat stables. They still exist today. You can still see them. Everything except a chicken stable, which is gone. The guy who sold it to us explained that there was like an old opening for the chickens. So he guesses that this room where this old openings can still be seen. So we are skipping a little bit of the history because we are going to the second floor. The house was occupied by two generations of family for a long time. In the second floor, there lived the grandmother who built this house. I think he said she died in like the 1980s or something like that. This floor wasn't used since she died, so it was original. You can go in there and there is beds from 1930. We removed the wallpapers and we can still see how it originally looks. For example, we can still see that the house was originally complexly painted. Also, we found some weird dates on the walls. There are walls that say 1996, as well as we found notes of the guys who put the wallpaper on the walls. After leaving the second floor, we are going to the attic. I will live in the attic. I will get the entire third floor. I think it's the historically most interesting room. As far as we know, it wasn't changed for over 80 or 90 years. The attic has four rooms. Technically, it has one really big room as well as two tiny ones, as well as an old pigeon loft. I don't know a lot about the pigeon loft. I looked one time up there and I was warned by the previous owners that if I step my foot on there, they can't be sure that I will not break through the ceiling. There were two small rooms. As I said, one will be my streaming or recording room. We know that these rooms were rented after the Second World War, which is really interesting because this house is in a really old village, but it's a one-horse town. Like, there's one street, like a really old church and a really old smithery, and that's it. But they rented these rooms to people. Also, on the attic, we found this, like, hidden chamber. Like, we cleaned and removed some of the isolation by mistake. We found a literally war equipment. Like, the second floor, this attic wasn't like maintained, so we found a shit ton of interesting details about the house. For example, we found two tiny alcohol bottles on top of the wardrobe that should have belonged to a child living there, which could imply that they were hidden from parents or something similar. We also found, like I said, a lot of like German Warbox in there, as well as we found like one cupboard that was filled with old family pictures. I will come to a conclusion because I'm talking way too long about this and I don't have that many recordings. So, picture of a cat. Another picture of a cat. I have some pictures of cats. Another picture of a cat. It's a beautiful house. It will take a shit ton of time to fix it. So yeah, hope you had fun with the unusual video. I recorded way too long. I need to edit this now.